In functional illness, it's a whole body process, okay? Pathological illness is local, okay? You can identify the injured tissue. Medicine has been led by our experience in warfare, and that's why our ability to heal trauma is so amazing. The tissue is broken, or you have an ulcer, the tissue is destroyed, you have a heart attack, you know, it's local area. And in that, so that's the CDR1 in a way, that local tissue destruction, okay? Because, and you know, when you have that destruction, you have to get rid of, you then have that CDR1, which begins to call in the immune system, and you begin to chew up the dead cells. And then you get into CDR2, which is when you have to call in stem cells and growth factors and begin to rebuild tissue. Okay. And so that's still local. Okay. And then you get to CDR3, where that cell has to mature and the cell membrane has to normalize, because in CDR1, you harden your cell membrane. Okay. Because you want to prevent egress of the viruses, or, and you also want to prevent other bad things from getting in. But in CDR3, that cell membrane is normalizing now, and the receptors for hormones and cell-to-cell communication is being restored, okay? And so now we're getting to that area of function. Now the cell is going to return to becoming a fully adult member of society, okay? So it knows the rules, it can begin to interact, okay? And that's when we start getting to this area of functional medicine, because now it's about signaling that's not working well, okay? So the tissue is kind of back to pretty much normal, but it's no longer listening as well as it should to the communication around it, okay? Or the communicate, or it's getting persistent low-level inflammatory signals, not enough to kick it back into the CDR1, but enough to not let it mature completely. So here we have functional medicine. You know, the functional part is about cellular communication, okay? And that is really coming from the brain on some level, okay? Because you see, you have local tissue damage, okay? And then you have the signals that the war is over that has to come from the brain. When I say aging is chronic inflammation, it's because chronic inflammation means we haven't restored full cellular communication in the body. Mm-hmm. Okay. So in a way, it's really poor communication. Because, I mean, when you think about it from a psychological point of view, what is everyday stress in relationships about? Is we're miscommunicating. You know, that's why when you go to the therapist, sometimes if you're lucky, if you go to family therapy, you can suddenly hear what the other person has been trying to tell you. But what happens in times of fighting, whether it's in war or just in dealing with your spouse who is foolish enough to not realize how right you are all the time, is people aren't listening to each other. You've stopped hearing. And that's what your cells do, the exact same thing. They stop listening to each other. And so when we want to heal, we have to create the environment that lets cells know that they're healthy. So on one hand, we have the micro, which is the local, the pathology. And I love to study the pathology. And the pathology is full of these micro details of which chemical and which protein or enzyme or gene is off. That is a fascinating world. But if you really want to get back to health, you also have to engage your favorite organ, which is the central nervous system, the brain, in giving the all clear signal that it's safe, because safety is what allows healing.